Today's email comes from Jane in Port Orange, Florida, and Jane has this to say. Dear RV Doctor, my black water tank appears to be leaking by the underbelly of my basement. That's not a good thing. It only leaks when it's about half full. Can I access the tank and repair it on site? We have a 2004 RV that we live in, and there's no easy way to transport it to a repair site. Any advice would be helpful. Well, Jane, a couple things I want to mention about plastic holding tanks, plastic freshwater storage tanks. They're typically made of plastic, as you know, and the plastic is usually polyethylene or ABS plastic. Most holding tanks could be either polyethylene or ABS. Most freshwater storage containers for your freshwater, they're typically polyethylene for the most part. The good thing about plastics like that, they're called thermoplastics. They can be heated and reheated over and over, and it really doesn't change the molecular structure of the plastic. The problem is when there's a crack, especially a crack halfway up the tank, one of the things you're going to have to find out is exactly where that crack is. So you are going to have to gain access to it at some point in time. Now that may involve halfway disassembling cabinets or sofas, depending on where your access is. Now you say yours is in the basement, so it's probably fairly easy to get to at least one side. You may use some mirrors, or as I tell my technicians, you have to have a trained mouse in your toolkit to go back in there and scope it out for you. But possibly with some mirrors and flashlights, you'll be able to see exactly where the crack is. If it's someplace you can get to, there is a thing you can do, what I call in a temporary basis only. On the market, in the aftermarket, if you go to RV accessory stores, you'll see what they call permanent patch kits, permanent holding tank repair kits available. Now, I would not guarantee with 100% certainty that if we apply that patch kit, that crack is not going to open up or continue again. The only surefire way with 100% certainty to repair a plastic holding tank or a plastic freshwater storage container is by plastic welding. Plastic welding comes with an expertise of sorts. Technicians are trained to do plastic welding. Certified RV techs basically go through a schooling process where they're trained to use a plastic welder such as this one right here. This one here happens to be the one I used when I was actually turning wrenches in a shop. And I could repair plastics, and I would guarantee with 100% certainty that repair would not fracture again somewhere down the road. You got to remember, you've got heavy water inside of a holding tank and waste, and you're sloshing it around and you're bouncing around down the highway. And these tanks are soft and pliable enough, even though it's high density polyethylene probably, it's still going to bounce around and create some stresses that could cause that fracture to open up again. So the important thing is to find out exactly where that crack is located. It concerns me that you say it happens when it's only half full, because there's not that many things attached to the sides of holding tanks. In this photo here, you'll see the side wall of a holding tank that has an attachment for a freshwater backfilling device so that you can flush out the holding tank. And you also see in this photo that you have some monitor probes so that you can monitor the level of the contents in the tank. These are connected directly to your monitor panel inside the coach. Push the button, find out how much content is in that particular tank. Those are the only things that basically attach to the sidewalls of the holding tank. For the most part, all of the drains from your receptacles, such as the sinks or the shower and the toilet, they all enter a holding tank from the very top. All the vents are connected at the very top. There's nothing that really connects to the sidewalls of the tank. So it concerns me the fact that you may have a mounting problem. Perhaps it's not supported properly. Perhaps there's the construction of the tank is built with a kind of a shelf to it, or an offset that may be causing some stress. So you probably should have a professional technician take a look at it. Now, you say you can't move the coach, but there are some certified technicians, some really, really good certified technicians that are mobile. They'll come out to you. So look for a mobile service, an RV service facility in your area. Make sure they're certified. The key is they have to be certified technicians because they've had to have passed a certification process to attain that certification. And in that process, we teach technicians how to do plastic welding. Now, if you opt for one of these aftermarket kits that you'll find on the shelves of auxiliary or of parts stores, that is a temporary repair only. I would only quantify that as a temporary repair. It will get you to through your trip and onto your home destination at some point in time, but I would consider them only temporary, even though it says permanent repair right on the packaging. I can't trust them. I would not warranty them, whereas I can guarantee with 100% certainty with the plastic welding. So be leery of these patch kits. Another thing that you could try once you gain access to where the actual patch or where the actual crack is to patch it by using Eternabond. Eternabond tape is a great aftermarket product used for many different functions. I've used it to seal anything attached to the roof, seams, vents, opening vents, reefer vents, anything that's attached to the top of the RV, Eternabond tape will seal. It's available in the aftermarket, and I've used it to plug holes underneath the coach to keep critters from crawling up inside the floor. It's great stuff. You can use it just about anywhere. Every RV handy person should have a roll of this Eternabond tape in their toolkit. You may try using that. Make sure the side of the tank is very clean and dry. Obviously, the content should be below that level of the tank. But you can rough it up with some sandpaper, clean it really well, make sure it's dry, and then apply the Eternabond tape. That probably would actually work a little bit better than the holding tank patch kits that are available in the aftermarket. Now, I've not done an A/B test on that, but the way I've used Eternabond in the past tells me it would probably be a good method of trying to patch, at least temporarily, your holding tank crack. But Jane, in all honesty, it needs to be plastic welded. That's the only way to, with 100% certainty, to guarantee that it won't crack again. Hope this helps.